Hey, hi, hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Long War versus the Art of War Comparison. Today we are continuing the talk about builds and we are going to go to a first very different class than anything you would have seen in the Long War. It's the Sleeper. A Sleeper is, I am assuming, a soldier with latent psionic and superior abilities that are not within the range of what a normal human without an alien DNA can do, but he is not exactly gene modded. So this is a very interesting class because it can perform functions that no other soldiers can do. It can be either a tank that is quite amazing, or as your long-range support, or your scout, or your killer, or basically anything you want. But I have a couple of builds in mind that you may find interesting. It's been a lot of fighting with myself over that. I couldn't decide what I really want this class to be in my games, but I finally decided. So basically, you have three options for this guy. You can go either for the tanky build that can kill enemies and sustain himself despite enemy fire in the field. He may actually even be as good as your regular tank if you're not facing mechanical units. Or we have a close range assassin that is getting close to the enemies, scouting the battlefield, ignoring enemy overwatches and basically murder fucks the enemies in the face, while at the same time avoiding enemy fire. Or the last option is sort of a support. The guy's job is going to be a long range killer support, so to speak, that basically makes the first kill during the turn against the weakest possible enemy and provides the whole squad with buffs. So yeah, let's start with the tanky build, shall we? On Lance we have a choice between Rapid Fire, Close Encounters and Charge. On Lance Corporal, Rapid Fire allows you to shoot twice every turn, of course, but with minus 15 aim penalty. Close Encounters give you a free shot within 4 tiles and Charge is Charge. You can, basically double move and then shoot on Overwatch. And that is basically the thing that we want for this squad. We want charge because we want to set up ourselves close to the enemy and still manage to shoot at them, which is important. You can, if you have a high mobility soldier, take close encounters so that you don't have to run and gun to the enemy. Of course, you can take close encounters and give the soldier a shotgun so that he gets both the charge and close encounters. However, with higher tier weapons, the perks provided by weapons will change, so do take that in consideration. Of course, in that situation, we are going with the charge, because what we want is to be able to, throughout the whole game, get close to the enemy and hold them in their tracks, and the close encounters is not as useful in that regard, since you will be running and gunning close to the enemy most of the time. Now, on Corporal we have Subdermal Plating, which gives you 1 damage reduction with stacks with all other sources. So basically you can put as much in this soldier as you can and make him a very early game tank that is very, very effective in the field, and then later only improve upon it. Or you can have Muscle Fiber Density that allows you to jump on rooftops and stuff like that. Or Adaptive Lensing that gives you plus 10 aim on any shot after a miss. We want, of course, Subdermal Plating because we are planning this guy to be a tank. On Soldier we have the Adrenal Neurosympathy that gives a buff to all the allied soldiers nearby once this unit kills an enemy. We don't really want this guy. Bioelectric skin allows you to sense enemies that you don't see and thus effectively scout the battlefield. We don't care about that. But regenerator gives you plus 2 health regeneration, but not armor regeneration, every turn. And we want that to increase survivability of the soldier. Now, on Tech Sergeant we have the choice between aggression that gives you additional crit chance per visible enemy, lone wolf that gives you 6 aim and crit chance if not within 7 tiles of allied unit, or tactical sense that provides you defense per visible enemy. We don't want tactical sense because that would be very counterproductive. We want the soldier getting shot at. So you have a choice between lone wolf and aggression. It depends on whether you you reckon will put your soldier far or nearer to the whole squad of yours. I usually don't find my tanks further than 7 tiles from the rest of the squad, so I'm going with aggression so we can get close and still hit our enemy very, very heavily. Now, on Gunnery Sergeant, this is again a very choice for you. It's about survivability, because you have the choice between Vital Point Targeting, which increases damage against enemies you have Autopsied and Exalt from all your weapons. You have Lightning Reflexes that allows you to ignore Overwatches for a price of tossing a coin, basically. And Bloodworks, that means that if the soldier dies, he is guaranteed to bleed out and not die. So, this is again up to you. The my choice is Vital Point Targeting, because Bloodworks are very useful. It is also increasing the fatigue time between missions, just as all the gene modded perks that are in the tree. So you may want to consider how often are you going to be able to take the soldier in the field if you put him all over the place with gene mods. And also, I don't plan on my soldiers ever dying, because I'm naive like that. And I want to capitalize on aggression and not only add that more crit chance, but also give more damage to that. So I'm usually going with VPT. However, if you feel paranoid of losing a soldier, Bloodworks is going to guarantee that he's not going to die on you so easily. Now, last but not least, on Master Sergeant, there is choice between Slayer, Dead Dealer, which is dealt in the zone, meaning that if you kill an enemy, it doesn't cost any actions, and you can keep killing as long as you're killing. And the Slayer confers bonus damage on critical hits. But what we want is Will to Survive, because it grants us additional 1.5 points of damage reduction, in addition to cover and stuff like that. So basically we have 2.5 damage reduction, just flat on the guy's skin on Master Sergeant, which means that he can pretty much ignore early sectoid fire, even up to floaters, to be honest. With just the basic armor, he doesn't have to give a fuck. If that's not a Slayer aggression enemy, he's not going to care at the early game. Of course, you're not going to have a Master Sergeant at early game. I'm just using this as a comparison. Now, as for the gear you want to give this guy, you want, of course, to give him tank armor, because you will want him in half cover most of the time, but not as much to avoid him being hit as to make sure that he gets hit. You know what I mean? So yeah, you are giving him as much as you can when it comes to defense. So as you see, we are right now packing basically 3-4 damage reduction just as we stand right now. And that is just the very basic, right? So yeah, that was the tank sleeper build. Now, let's move on to the next one. And here we are. Oh, of course, I forgot to speak about the first perk that you're getting. Neural Dampening is basically giving you protection against psionic attacks and makes it impossible for the soldier to be mind controlled. So that's a very good thing, right? Anyway, the next build I wanted to talk about is an assassin build. This guy is going to get close to the enemy, he's going to scout the field for you, he's going to operate sort of behind enemy lines. You want to wiggle him behind your enemy so that they are getting confused and the rest of the squad can open fire, and he is going to basically utilize flanks at close range to make the enemy very, very, very dead, very, very, very hard. So yeah, we are taking close encounters, because we want to be able to fire, to have a free action if we are firing at the close range, which is obviously very good. Now, what we are going to be having is muscle fiber density, because it allows you a very easy access to height advantage, and you can use it almost all the time that way. Alternatively, you can take adaptive lensing, but that's not really the point. You are going to usually be having close to 100% of hitting the enemy most of the time in any case. Now, on the next one, you want bioelectric skin, because you want to know where the enemies are before they see you, so that you can position yourself and then activate them with the rest of your squad, then move in with your sleeper and start taking the toll on the enemy. On Tech Sergeant, you want a Lone Wolf, because this guy is going to operate away from the enemy squad. On Gunnery Sergeant, you want Lightning Reflexes, because you are going to be probably running Overwatches. However, you can take Vital Point Targeting for additional damage, and which is what I'm going to be taking. because quite frankly, with the sleeper is very rarely going to actually have to see combat for the second turn, because an emissary is usually going to simply be dead. And last but not least, we are taking Dead Dealer, which is the old in the zone. So as you see, this is the build that is almost exactly as the mod author intended, because he kind of set up the builds in you know, the fall down trees. And this one is actually right there, to be honest, because it's just way too effective not to mention that build. So yeah, basically what we are going to be having in here is a heavy hitter that doesn't activate the enemy but locates them for you. The rest of the squad, for example your Rocketeer, activates the enemy, they are taking cover from the rest of the squad, then they are going to be flanked by your sleeper and they are going to be deaded very, very hard, because with the in the zone there is simply very little that can survive. Assuming that you already wounded the pod. So this guy is basically coming out there and mopping up the floor with you. So yeah, as you can see, we are taking the tag vest in here, there is no changes. We want the biggest amount of mobility possible and we want half cover to count as full, because rooftops usually are half cover. Now, we are taking a rifle, not a shotgun. Imagine that. Why not a shotgun? It would work very, very well, you say. That's true, but... Wait, I think I'm being mistaken in here. What do we have? We have 4 ammo plus 1. 4 plus 1. Actually, you are taking a shotgun. I don't know why I thought that the shotgun has less ammo. However, you may take a rifle alternatively, because we are often going to be seeing enemies like Seekers, drones and later Mectoids and stuff. So if you are worried about that, take a rifle instead of a shotgun. You are not going to be dealing as much damage maybe, but you are not going to be completely stopped by damage reduction, which is bloody important, right? Now, we don't need any kind of trophies or anything, but you do want laser sights so that your Overwatches fire multiple times, maybe a self-medkit, items that give you additional crit chance and additional damage are absolutely bloody important. So yeah, that was it about the assassin build. Now let's move on to the last. Now, the last build I wanted to talk about is a long-range... long-range damage dealer and support. What this guy is going to do is he's going to take a maximum available possible damage you can into the enemy so that he dies and the rest of your team can face stronger opponents with improved aim, crit and stuff like that. So what we want here is rapid fire for the start, because you want to hit your enemy twice, and the minus 15 aim is going to be pretty big problem, but it can be mitigated with small items. Mind you, the adaptive lensing for this build doesn't really make any sense, because why, yes, it does impose plus 10 aim after to any shot after a miss, but not to rapid fire second shot. So we are not going to actually be using, we are taking muscle fiber density instead, because it allows the soldier to easily grab high cover, easily grab high elevation and get the plus 10 aim from being higher than the enemy anyway, for both of the shots, which is what we are going to want. Now, Adrenal Neurosympathy is the whole core of the build, because once you get a kill, all the allies in radius are going to get buffed, which is what you want. You'd have to remember to keep the sleeper in the middle of your formation, even though you want to have him to be higher than the rest of them, so he can, you know, have the additional aim for the rapid fire. It is doable on most of the maps. Now, you want aggression for this guy, because he gets plus 10 critical chance per visible enemy. I don't think there is anything I can really say to that. You want that, because it's good. Same goes for vital point targeting, because it improves your base damage as well as your intended damage, because you have the plus 2 base damage, plus that works into the modifier of your crit damage. And speaking of crit damage, Slayer gives you more crit damage per enemy inside, which allows you to crit the enemies very, very strongly with very little effort. And as you can see, this also is a build that has almost no variety from the stock, But adaptive lensing replaced with muscle fiber density is an important change that you are going to be requiring quite often for a very simple reason. Adaptive lensing basically only works to you for your consecutive turn, while being higher than the enemy works for you every turn. Now, as for the loadout, this guy is using a heavy rack. You want it to be in position before you open fire, and you want to rapid fire without moving, because that way you can basically hit your enemy harder than with the rifleman rack, and you can carry drum magazines to have more ammo, plus a scope or a laser sight to mitigate the aim a little more. Because you don't really need some amazing amounts of damage on this guy, you want to kill that stray sectoid, that stray drone, so that all the rest of the squad works better, rather than just become a solo hero for the team. So yeah, that is basically it about the sleeper. So yeah, let me know if you like this video. If so, if you have any questions and stuff, I will try to answer in the comments. And for now, I'm going to say thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. If so, press the like button, follow me on Facebook, subscribe to the channel if you feel like it, and I will be seeing you again in the next one. For now, I've been Falek. See you later, guys.